I think Whitechapel Charlie's got some work if you're looking. He's down in the third rail.
Ooh. I'm always a fan of attaining more side missions. Even though that's going to keep on delaying and delaying the main story a little bit more.
Entertainment down the stairs.
Oh, I know about the entertainment, all right. Sometimes it just says mean words to me.
Hell of a load you're carrying. Better sell some to Daisy before someone swipes it.
Running from something? Welcome home.
How do people know what I have on me? Like, do they just know I have 300 pounds worth of stuff? Just chilling out in my back pocket? Guess it's just an instinct.
Hey, Magnolia.
Something I can do for you, handsome?
Flirt, any chance I could steal you away for an evening? Huh, I guess I could just keep on doing that.
Do you know Imogene Cabot?
Imogene? Sure. I know her. I haven't seen her in a while, though. Are you a friend of hers?
I just need to talk to her. She's missing and her family's worried.
She's missing, and her family's worried about her.
Well, I'm glad somebody's looking out for her. She seemed like a body that could use looking after.
Please, tell me what you know.
There was this preacher fella who used to come in here all the time. One of the slick ones. Always going on about remaking your life and so on. Most of the customers wouldn't give him the time of day, but Imogene, she latched on to him for some reason. I don't suppose it hurt that he was easy on the eyes. Intense. Some women find that irresistible.
Pam, would you come over here a minute?
Who the hell is Pam?
Is there a problem, Miss Magnolia?
No, this fine gentleman here was just looking for Imogene. Do you happen to know where that preacher fella came from?
Brother Thomas?
Yes, that's right. The one Imogene was always hanging on.
Had to throw him out. Wouldn't stop bothering customers with that salvation racket. Kept going on and on about joining him at the back bay. Then he'd shove those stupid flyers in your face. Here, I kept one of them, just in case he didn't pay his bar tab.
Well, thanks, honey. You were a big help.
Anything for you, miss.
I hope Imogene's all right. I didn't much like the idea of her going off with that preacher fella.
Yeah, not a single good thing has happened in the Fallout series that I know of that's happened with religious people.
Back. Drinks in my pleasant company still available.
That sounds mean towards people that are religious in real life, but I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, I mean, we have the cult of Adam, we have whatever's gonna happen here. It's just always sketchy stuff.
What's the word around town?
Well, they say there's a newcomer around here who doesn't understand that I'm a bartender, not a damn juice pop. Now, are you gonna drink?
No, white chap. Well, I guess I could buy a beer.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Nothing watered down.
That way he goes, you're a paying customer. Boom. I'm a paying customer.
Now that you're licked up, got a proposition for you.
Yeah.
I need a dirty boy to do some dirty, dirty work. Blood on the pavement, bodies in the ground, that kind of thing. Interested?
I want to hear the details first.
I got a certain anonymous client who's paying top dollar for a clean-up job. 3 locations. Everyone inside. No witnesses. Only catch? It's all in town. The old warehouses, so I can't use my regulars. Too noticeable. That's where you come in. The job's 200 caps. Payment after it's done. And don't worry. I'll know when it is.
Okay. Well, I'm going to need to get A, more money, and B, I'm going to need to know some details.
I don't do work unless I know who's paying the bills.
All right, Gov. Not like it's a big secret who I represent. Mayor Hancock is fronting the caps. Internal political struggle. You know how it is. Look, it's nothing you need to be concerned about. Just clear out the warehouses and get paid. Simple.
But I want more money for it.
3 locations? That's a lot of time. A lot of bullets.
Well, I guess we could sweeten the pot a bit. 250.
Too low. Barely covers the risks.
All right, Gov. 300.
More money,
Charlie.
Giving me a right kick in the elbows. We'll make it 400, but that's as high as I'm going.
I'll get it done.
You better. Now go out there and bust some heads.
I like how a lot of these missions where we can actually raise the cap limits don't actually go up that high in comparison to like what we have nowadays, right? Like we can get, we have a 14,000 caps and 400 is supposed to sound like a lot to me. Come on, man.
Enjoy your stay.
I'm not a fresh new face in the wasteland anymore. You gotta raise that up to like 800. I mean, I still don't know the value of caps in this world, but it would be nice. Okay, so we need to go into these warehouses. I was always wondering, I'm like, what the hell are these warehouses? Where do they lead? Well, now we know. They lead to the warehouse, but I have a mission for it, so that's good.
Sweet.
I hope these are a bunch of raiders. Ah, Sugarman. he pulled out his weapon and then put it away. Nah, you shouldn't have indicated that you knew I was here, buddy. That's how you die. You've been caught stealing. The owner is now hostile.
Come out and I'll sue you.
Where'd that come from?
But the question is, who's the owner? That has me worried. Because if it's the trigger man, then it doesn't matter. But if it's, say, Cleo, or Daisy,
hey, bring it on.
Then I'm in trouble with the actual town.
I'm feeling eyes on my back. That's how we do things around here.
I think that's it. Yep, that's it. All right. Yeah, well, it's free. It's free liking points. At least from MacReady. Oh, look, they have a little doghouse here. We're taking that too. Thankfully, there were no dogs in here for me to kill, because then I'd feel bad about it. What is up with all this stuff? We killed anybody who would actually know that we're stealing these things. So I want to operate under the assumption that we don't have to worry about the fact that we've been caught. But we're gonna keep on ascending up this building because just maybe there's someone surviving. Doesn't really look like it. Oh, these fucking mannequins. What is up with them, man? There are so many of them just all over the wasteland. Ooh, hello. I really need to find a happy balance. I gotta lower the brightness of this light, which will make it really annoying when it's nighttime again, but at least I increased the distance of it. Jeez. Oh, blinding light! This isn't even the bright version. This is just the dim light with a slightly brighter texture. I need like a middle ground between the slightly brighter and then the normal one. Maybe I should go into the files myself. Learn how to mod a little bit. You know, I always let others do the work, and sometimes that leads to disappointing results. But if all I have to do is go into a texture file in Photoshop and decrease the brightness myself, that's something I can do. I know my way around Photoshop. Somewhat. Alright, so we know there's a second warehouse is, but we're gonna walk outside. I refuse to quick save until I see that the town is not hostile. Because I'm still really suspicious as to what's going to actually happen. Oh, damn it. I was hoping MacReady was right behind me. MacReady, I want to talk to you. What do you think about our current situation? Damn it, MacReady.
Hey.
Hope this helps.
Your thoughts?
I hate to admit it, but I'm starting to enjoy this little deal we have going.
Your thoughts?
Never thought I'd see the day where someone's watching my back for a change.
Your thoughts?
I'd kill for a drink. Come to think of it, I have.
Your thoughts?
Play your cards right, and we stand to make a whole lot of money.
That's exactly what we're doing.
Didn't have anything else.
Sure.
All right. MacReady is like the almost perfect companion for stuff. He's totally fine with me being money-grubbing sometimes. But he also wants me to be a nice individual. And so, that's a win-win. The only negatives are that he doesn't really react to too many other things. So it takes a while to raise up his affinity with me. I can't just pick-lock my way into his heart. But he's totally fine with me breaking into places and stealing stuff, so hey, there's that.
I'll make this quick, buddy! Idiot!
That's what I call a confirmed kill.
I'll make this quick! Yeah, I'll just take your fedora and your black vest and slacks. This is actually really nice looking. I should equip one of my settlements with just all fancy outfits.
What a waste of time.
I'll make my gods wear these outfits. And then I'll make all the non-guards wear other kinds of things. Just normal suits, maybe some laundered dresses. Oh look, there's more! We'll shoot you, and you... No! AP, damn it! That was gonna be one of the first and only times so far where we actually use my VATS on multiple targets and kill multiple targets. Oh well. Ah, that tickles.
Impressed yet?
I guess bleeding out does kind of tickle a little bit.
Come on,
feels a little weird. Damn it, I really just wanted to run into them like a bowling pin. Or a bowling ball, and they would be like bowling pins. And I don't want normal suits. So I'll take their guns, money and all that. Ooh, hello. What do we got in here? Oh. I was really excited, I was like, the bag is glowing, what could be inside? Nope, just handcuffs. People are into weird things, like holding people hostage, and then possibly demanding money of them. So I wonder if I could have gotten this mission like a really long time ago. If all I had done, if all it takes to actually get this mission is to buy some alcohol, and gain the bartender's trust, then I probably could have done this hours ago. On my first run through Good Neighbor. Just be standing in this place and have to deal with these triggermen. And that would have been my first encounter with them, rather than when we had to try and save Nick Valentine. Speaking of Nick Valentine, I should probably go grab him sometime after we're done with McCready. But I still haven't made a list of like which perks I'm trying to get from who. Because I know that Preston can give me some good stuff. Curie can give me something good. Oh boy. And then obviously we can get a couple of other companions across the wasteland that we haven't gotten yet. Alright, where's this third warehouse? I should actually select this mission. Imogene takes a lover. That's straightforward. It could have just been like, Imogene finds religion. Okay, is it probably gonna be under mist? Clear out the Good Neighbor warehouses. Yep, there you go. Where is the third warehouse? I guess it's right there. All right. It's kind of really visible. Oh, we'll be fine. Okay. Damn it. Stupid bobby pins, not being consistent. You know, it'd be really funny if opening up the warehouse door.
Hold up. And a lot of boxes, okay?
Pushed me out.
Just hold on to your ass.
It's like all I'm good for is waiting around. Jesus.
All right, we gotta find these guys. Hello.
Ah!
Been waiting all day for this freaking time!
Oh, I was actually hoping he would blow up his head. Alright. We wait around the corner. We wait for them to come to us, and then this staircase will just be bathed in the Triggerman's blood. I see your shadows, friends. Come on over.
Enjoy your coffin! Disappearing act ain't fooling me.
It's not showing much of the animation. It's just kind of floating around like, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Fraidy cat. Too scared?
That's not what I want.
Getting rained on over here.
Still trying to chill out by the stairs. Hello.
Could have sworn
you heard something. Don't worry, I can definitely hear it. Hello. Oh, that had to suck. All right.
Whatever you dish out, I do you double.
Yeah, I don't think I need the bloody perk or bloody mess perk for that one. All right, how do I get up to that guy? Ah, here we go. Okay, there you go. We've killed all the Triggermen around here. Easy peasy, all done in a single night. I should be paid extra for that. I have the speed and kind of the stealth. I don't think people are gonna miss the Triggermen. A bunch of low-level thugs? Yeah. And I'm not just referring to the fact that they're level 7. I just mean they don't do much in life. Alright. I'm gonna have to slowly walk around this place and steal everything. But thankfully, we're next to like 5 vendors. Cleo, Daisy, Whitechapel, Charlie. We have the couple of people inside of the hotel. So we'll be fine.
Sweet Pip-Boy, brother. You hold on to that.
I've heard some exterminator cleaned out the rats in the old warehouses. Wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
Rats? What are you talking about? I might. Depends on what you have for me. Yeah, play along.
I might. Depends on what you have for me.
Here you are. Every single cap. As agreed.
Yeah, thank you, Whitechapel. You have any other jobs?
My client appreciates the work you did with his rat problem. Now, if you're buying, let's hear what you want. He
asked me what. Oh, there's nothing else. All right. Said I need a
favor. Let's see what you got.
Nothing watered down.
What if I buy another beer from you, buddy?
Hey, Charlie.
Order up. I'll forever hold your damn mouth shut.
You know what? I'm leaving. Thank you, Charlie.
Hell of a load you're carrying. Better sell some to Daisy before someone swipes it.
I already sold a whole bunch of stuff. Now I just have to actually drop off some other things. Whoa, okay. Drop off some other things so that way my weight goes down just a bit. But I sold all the weapons. And I just have to drop off these things. So where the hell am I supposed to be going for that other mission? Hold up. So we're looking for this chick, and she is over here by the waterfront. Okay, that works. We can fast travel over to like Hallucigen Inc. and walk over there. Uh-oh. There's raiders about. I'm not looking to deal with them though. I'm just trying to find the girl. Find the girl, bring her back. Someone just shot a rocket. We're not worried about him. Oh, hey! This looks like an interesting place. Missionary. Oh. Some of them are nice, some of them aren't. We're gonna be worried about that guy. We'll put away our gun, just in case. Hello! I am here on a peaceful mission!
Whoa. Help! Ain't my fight!
Shit!
Someone do something!
Hello, neighbor.
Why the heck is there so much light in here?
Hi.
You should talk to Brother Thomas about how to join our movement.
Yeah, you guys are kind of creepy.
Hey there.
I hope you decide to become one of the pillars of the community.
Please stop walking towards me.
Hey.
Welcome.
He's walking towards me, man. He's just walking at me.
Here to learn about our movement? Wow, would you look at that?
He's right behind us, man!
I'm just passing through.
Well then, fate must have brought you to us today. This is your chance to change your life for the better.
Welcome, neighbor. We're always glad to see a new face around here. Tell me something. You ever feel like this whole world is broken? Do you ever wonder why things can't be the way they were in the good old days?
The whole world is broken.
The whole world is broken.
That's what I used to think. Until I found a way to make a difference. To transform my life. And maybe everyone else's too. We call ourselves the Pillars of the Community. We're a pretty new movement, so you may not have heard of us. But we're growing fast all across the Commonwealth, and you can be part of this exciting future. Step right this way, and I'll be happy to tell you all about our movement and how you can be a part of it.
Sounds good!
Sounds good.
Well, that's just fantastic. I know you're going to fit right in around here.
I'll play along.
Right this way, neighbor.
I will play along. Let's see what happens. We'll also take my fusion core out, so don't worry about that. Okay, it's not gonna get stolen. I mean, wouldn't it be weird as we try to make our lives better?
I'm always excited to welcome a new member into our fold.
And I am just in like a super big power armor? Ooh. Are you gonna lock me in this room until I decide to comply to your ways?
Don't be shy. Just follow me.
You're putting yourself in a bad situation. Alone in a room with a random person who might be a raider?
Alrighty. I hope you're as excited as I am. This is one of my favorite parts of the job. Getting to welcome new members into our movement. The first step is simple. You have to learn to give up your attachment to material possessions in order to gain the ability to have true wealth, health, and happiness. Just go ahead and give me everything you own, and I'll initiate you as a first-level pillar of the community.
Yeah, right, buddy. You know where you can shove that pillar.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. You want me to give you everything I have?
You've gotta be kidding. You want me to give you everything I have?
The first step is the hardest, neighbor. But it's the only way to cast off your old life and start on the road towards your future health, wealth, and happiness. Don't you think that's worth a small, temporary sacrifice?
No.
What do I get in return for giving you everything I own?
You're still stuck in old thinking. You're still clinging to your old life. But that's what you came here to give up. And the first step is to shed yourself of your material possessions.
What if I've changed my mind and don't want to join anymore?
No, sorry. I'm afraid we're past that point. You really do need to give me everything. Now.
Oh, these guys are so fucking shady. Oh, wow.
You can't seriously think I'm handing over all my stuff.
The world is full of suckers, pal. Just look outside. Every one of them handed over everything they owned in return for... well, hope. Sure, it's false hope, but hey, it was worth it to them. You can tell yourself whatever you want, but you're leaving here naked or horizontal. Your choice.
Woo! Boy, he's changed! He has changed that tone! Oh, that is funny. Yeah, if I didn't have MacReady with me, I probably would try to give everything I own, so that way I could see what he tries to do. But we're gonna do a save.
I'm walking out of here. Your choice what you want to do about it.
That's not how this works.
So that's it, huh?
MacReady, kill! I'm just gonna sit here and watch! Oh, you got what you deserve, buddy.
Ow! How dare you! You shoot me, you die!
Someone help! Leave me alone!
This isn't my fault!
Help me!
You guys submitted yourselves to this fool!
Kill him!
Oh, you're getting back up. That's cute. Holy shit! Oh, let's see. Amphitheater's key. Oh, I guess he has her locked away somewhere. Hold on. All right. I want to see what happens if I succeed in telling him, no, I'm not giving you everything.
I'm walking out of here. Your choice what you want to do about it.
That's not how this works.
That is exactly how this works. I'm a Jedi. I wave my hand in your face and you're like, okay.
I'm walking out of here. Your choice what you want to do about it.
That's not how this works.
I'm walking out of here.
Nah. You're not worth the trouble. Plenty of easier marks. Get out of here before I change my mind.
That's funny. There you go. Eventually he's like, ah,
this place
right.
looks untouched. How's that possible?
How do you mean this place looks untouched? The amphitheater? It looks super touched. By the way. Okay, what is going on? Mutants? Those look like raiders. And obviously there are probably Brotherhood guys around. Hey there.
I'm looking for Imogene Cabot.
Not that it's any of your business, but she and I are just having a little relationship trouble. You know how it is. She's not seeing anybody until she cools off.
Maybe 500 caps will make her available. What?
You're not holding her prisoner, are you?
No, she's not a prisoner. She's just locked in her room until she calms down. She was acting crazy, threatening to run off. You know how women can get.
Yeah, we're gonna talk to you about stuff.
I'm a friend of the family. Maybe I can talk some sense into her.
Blah, blah, blah. Why are you even talking to these morons?
I said she wasn't seeing anybody, including you.
I'm going to see her, one way or another. Your choice.
Maybe they'd rather spend the last few seconds of their lives with a gaping hole in their chest.
Take it easy. If you want to see her so bad, don't let me stand in your way. Here, I'll unlock the door for you.
Damn right, Brother Thomas. Good thing there are two options for me to be able to persuade him. Is she still alive?
All yours,
pal. Well, look at that.
You must be Imogene.
Don't tell me. Jack sent you.
You're Jack's sister. I was expecting someone a bit younger.
You really know how to flatter a lady, don't you? Just to be clear, I'm Jack's younger sister. The baby of the family. Once I get home and get some of Jack's serum, I'll be back to my usual stunning self.
What? What? Hold up. The serum reverses aging?
Jack has a serum that reverses aging?
It's more like it halts aging. I started taking it when I was 32, so normally that's what I look like. You'll see once I get my treatment. I was well known as one of the belles of Boston society, back when there was any.
What? You've been around since...
What happens if you don't get more serum?
Oh, I don't think we need to worry about that. I've gone without a treatment much longer before with no lasting effect.
Yeah, whatever. Let's get going already.
It wasn't my idea for you to come down here poking your nose into my business.
I'm trying to rescue you. I was just trying to get the option out. Do you want to get out of here or not? Fine, I'll lock the door behind me on my way out.
You could be a little more grateful to the person who's rescuing you.
Oh, Thomas would have let me go eventually, but I was getting tired of waiting for him to come to his senses, so... Thank you. I was bored with Thomas anyway. He seemed so interesting at first, but after we got here, he turned out to be just another brute. He actually thought it could force me to join his absurd cult.
Your boyfriend Thomas was a real charmer.
I was done with him, and he shouldn't have locked me in here. Don't worry, I'll find my own way home. I'm not quite ready to face Mother. And thank you. I really do appreciate you coming to find me. even though I didn't actually need rescuing. I can find my own way home. Thanks.
Yeah, you say that, but we're just gonna close this door on you. So, Thomas!
Hey there.
We don't have anything to talk about.
Right, okay. Well, I was hoping that maybe I'd be able to talk to him and eventually get everybody to realize the errors of their ways, but it looks like that's not going to be an option, so oh well. Look at all these nice little suits they have. Okay. I want to see if there's anything I could take for myself. Yes.
Pretty slick.
Right? Just quick save. If they shoot me, that's gonna be their own death warrants. Look at all these watches and stuff. Damn! They even had a mini nuke. Who has a fucking mini nuke? I'm just making sure to take everything I can. Because this is a lot of stuff. Surveyor outfit. That sounds like fun. Take that. This looks like the stuff that Deacon was wearing. It probably is exactly what Deacon was wearing. Oh, hi there, everybody.
Hey.
I hope you decide to change your life today.
Holy shit, she looks creepy.
You should talk to Brother Thomas about how to join our movement.
Hi. We're always looking for new members. I hope you decide to become one of the pillars of the community.
Look at their face! Look at his face!
Hello, neighbor. Welcome.
It's so creepy!
Welcome. We're always looking for new members.
Dude.
You should talk to Brother Thomas about how to join our movement.
And everybody sounds the same, except for this one chick.
Hey.
I hope you decide to change your life today. Hello, neighbor.
And they're all wearing pompadours. Yeah, we're getting out of here. This is, it's a bad
place.
Hey
there.
I hope you decide to change your life today.
We didn't kill all these guys, so while they're going to have to continue living as, living lives as suckers, at least they're not going to be dead. Don't want to kill a whole bunch of innocent people. Is this chick wearing, no, that's the same chick. I was gonna say, is this chick wearing a pompadour?
Hello, neighbor. Welcome. We're always looking for new members. You should talk to Brother Thomas about how to join our movement.
Yeah, I think the only movement I want to join is the Jack Cabot movement. The one where you can apparently stop aging entirely and live through the apocalypse.